hours, you know, and just made to listen to ridiculousness. I mean, it's just absolute lies. And you know, a lot of them, my husband included, would go and, well, that doesn't sound right. You know, they would look up online and would know for themselves, but they weren't allowed to speak out against it.
Yeah.
You know, and so that, it's hard. And then even this campaign, there have been employees pulled into closed offices. What are you doing? What's going on? Knock it off. I don't want to see you doing that. You know, and it's, they're scared.
Yeah.
And they actually have their own policy within their manual that says that they will respect any worker's freedom of choice to choose any union representative they want, yet they don't enforce it. And I forgot to say, you know, in the Dallas area, we're actually running this tournament with the UFCW. You know, I know the Walmart guys were here, but UFCW 1000, you know, Grapevine is actually working with us on the Dallas side, too. And so that, you know, we got a combined campaign going on here with both areas, and we're trying, as a Teamsters as a whole, is if we can really find a way how to help these workers organize, can we springboard something nationally, starting in the southern region, you know, with these two Texas areas? We're going to put all the resources we can, and we want to tap into this program. Rob has actually been instrumental in kind of putting together just a kind of a brief. It's in draft mode. We haven't finalized it yet, but something that we're talking about when we talk about monitoring commission. And I have a letter here that, you know, if you all are interested, you know, you guys are willing to help us support that, you know, put your name and your email on the back of it, you know. We're just collecting signatures now. We're not putting anything out as it is. And I have some of my business cards. I'll pass these around for everyone to look at. But, you know, we want to really get involved and, you know, help tap into the community and, you know, whatever you all think that you all can help to, we'll try to coordinate it the best we can.
Cool.
Art, are you supporting the Coke boycott of the steel workers?
There's a huge boycott going on with KillerCoke.com, and the Teamsters have not signed on it to this point because we are the largest union representative of the workers, and we've tried to keep a political relationship. But as we're seeing, it's eroding right now, and they're deteriorating that relationship on a national basis, taking it away with us. And they're actually looking at shutting, you know, actually starting to get involved into that KillerCoke.com and the national protests that are going on against Coke because, you know, the eroding of our benefits, the eroding of the non-union workers' benefits, and the erosion of the relationship and negotiations with Coke has just been unbelievable.
It's like a great boycott.
So, yeah, this paper right here is the letter that we're putting out, so if you're interested in being part of our letter to Coca-Cola, we're gearing this towards more of a May thing because we haven't got the full support we want from the workers of Coke before we go forward. You just put your name and your email address on the back here. We'll email you more as it comes, but this is the draft letter that we're looking to put forward.
The executive board 6 months ago here at this local voted to take the Coke machine out and put in a Pepsi machine. they're still kind of mad about it.
That's a good message.
Doesn't taste the same.
That'll be good if we can get this local signed on to it.
Doesn't taste the same.
Sprite or some other Coke product, you know, that you can't get to Pepsi.
Right.
And so membership's still about half mad about it.
Dr. Pepper.
Is it anyone Who have any other questions at all?
Just one comment, which I truly believe, I've been around a little bit, that this may be our last chance for a lot of things, you know.
Mm-hmm.
The unions, I think, are acting correctly now as a joint effort, and we have to keep it a joint effort, not only the unions, Move On, Occupy, and so forth, because we're about, if we haven't already, about to lose our democracy as we know it. And we've got to fight it with everything we got.
Don't forget Hitler and Mussolini started with the trade unions.
Yeah, they sure as hell do.
Tom will tell you about Valenza.
Yeah, I could tell you about that. But
basically, Lech, they used to throw him out constantly.
Yeah, constantly. They threw him out of his, he'd go into his meeting and they'd throw him out. They wanted to get rid of Lech. And so they went in to organize him and they asked him what, they threw him out, said, you can't come back in. And they said that, I forget how they put it, it's been so long since I told the story, it's my problem. I wasn't thinking.
And basically what we're getting at is that's what they attacked, was he was trying to organize the dock workers, the so forth over there, and they just kept chucking him out. And when he finally got in there, and then he became president, because that's the first ones they hit, are the union people. You know, because it's not communism, it's not anything. These were the communists that were throwing them out. So, you know, and we've got a bad name because people relate us to, oh, that's socialism, that's communism. No, that's workers' rights. And that's what we got to stand for.
I appreciate that. I'm just in comparison, they just dished out the raises to Coca-Cola workers, which were no more. The highest person I heard was 3.7%, you know, just this, you know, last April. Well, some of that, you know, compiled to some workers only got 5 to 10 cents an hour raises. Their insurance got increased almost 20% this year.
With a lesser company, the company that, you know, doesn't provide as much, and then their negotiations were different. So our out-of-pocket is actually more. Even though the percentages are the same, you know, their contracted rate with UnitedHealthcare is much higher than what we have with Blue Cross. So we're paying so much more out-of-pocket for lesser quality healthcare from what we've been accustomed to.
And just as they dished that out, though, the USA Today ran a newspaper article, you know, headline news that, hey, CEOs are, you know, got some of the record lowest raises, but it's still, you know, the top 20 paid CEOs, Coca-Cola was like number 7. He got a 10% raise, which almost equivalent, I think, like $6 million. You know, and it was right there, in, you know, in our faces, in the workers' faces. I mean, it was just unbelievable. You know, this week will be the first paycheck they see with these raises, yet less the insurance, where they'll actually lose more money. And I have one worker that's worked 30 years as a bulk driver and has saved all the documentation he's given. He's shown in the last 30 years he's made less money than he did really 30 years ago, because they've continued to, no matter how much they increase, the benefits increase to continue just to decay the wages, so that no matter what, you're never gaining ahead.
Yep, flat line. Like Wallace used to preach for economic justice in the shipyards of Gdansk, Poland. And every time he did, they'd pick him up and carry him outside the wall and cast him into the dust. The last time he was laying in the dust, he picked himself up. He said, never again. Never again would he go back and then beg for his job. This time he was going over the wall. He went over the wall, he organized solidarity, and democracy was born in Eastern Europe for the courage of this man and a few others, and the strength of an idea of economic justice. That's how it happened.
Yep.
Just for what it's worth.
Yeah. See, I knew you'd get it.
Yeah. It's just my brain was working somewhere else.
That's all right.
One of the unions I'm a retiree from is Texas State Employees Union. And just recently, it was announced that the Texas State System for state workers was moving from Blue Cross Blue Shield to UnitedHealthcare. Now, it just so happens all UnitedHealthcare people in Texas were former legislative directors for Rick Perry, all connected to Rick Perry in some way. But you were talking about the difference between UnitedHealthcare and
Blue Cross. There are less doctors and hospitals contracted than there are with Blue Cross and Blue Shield, and the contracted rates between the physicians and the insurance was better with Blue Cross and Blue Shield. We were paying less out of pocket. You know, we pay at 20%. And asthmatic children, we use insurance and we depend on it a lot. And, you know, a regular office visit on Blue Cross would be $12. On United Healthcare, we're paying $18 and $19 each visit. You know, so, and that adds up over time. And with the, we've had to readjust our specialist for my children, you know, because they're not available. They don't accept United Healthcare. It's,
so that's when I'll be moving from Blue Cross. All state workers and retirees will be moving from Blue Cross to UnitedHealthcare because of the deal brokered by Rick Perry in September. So this is very interesting information. I'm going to tell the Texas State Employees Union leadership.
It just happened that I saw at a pediatrician where they had the contract sheet, the contracted rates, and it had Blue Cross and United Healthcare side by side, and it was just remarkable. On every single line, it was quite a bit more with United Healthcare.
Yeah. And they have a tier program where, you know, if you go into the first program, it's cheaper than the old premiums were, but it's $5,000 out of pocket before the policy even takes place. Then the next policy, if you want the high, you know, the high dollar plan, we're $110 to $200 biweekly for these plans. So that's almost $400, and if they have children with lots of disabilities or lots of children, you know, it continues to increase. You know, and then we've had people paying almost $800 a month just for basic health care over there, yet they're paying out their pockets still when they have to go, because it's still, you know, they only cover this procedure, and this one's covered at 80%, this one's covered at 50%.
5 years ago, we had 100% coverage.
Yeah.
And now we have 80-20 with a $750 deductible. You know, and that was with that plan. We could have chosen the high deductible plan with the $2,500 per person deductible, you know, before it ever even kicked in, and then it's still only 20% coverage. But the bonus with that was Coke gave us a $400 credit on our health savings account.
I say we push for single payer.
Exactly.
We need Medicare for all.
So far, everything we've talked about
employers connected.
As George pointed out, everything we've talked about so far, the training, the protests, the organizing with Walmart, and the protests of the fair trade for fair trade against free trade, they're all connected. And you can see why, even though we're all quite a disparate group from different organizations, you can see why we're all brothers and sisters, and we're growing more and more aware of that. Maybe we'd like to hear from our brothers and iron workers about what they're doing. What's Ryan going to be doing here in North Texas?
Ryan is, we hired Ryan full-time as a researcher and community organizer, and he's moved here to Dallas.
So you're going
to
have the new office?
He'll be working out of that new office.
It exists, yeah.
Corner office. So.
Okay. Where do you have the address yet?
Big window. It's going to be up on Reba Road.
All right.
And we're hoping that we close the deal this week, and we gave him our final offer on it. And it looks like, you know, we've been negotiating with the broker for the last 2 weeks, but it looks like we should close.
Well,
and
let's
then we'll have work to do in it once.
I think we should have a party.
We will have a party. Yeah. Once we got some work to do in there. We got some drywall to hang and mud there. So once we get that done, we'll be
I need to tell everyone that unless something changes, there will be no Job with Justice meeting next month. I couldn't get my wife to not schedule me to go on vacation.
I filed a very serious protest about that, too.
Right. I thought about a petition.
You need to get a better grievance handling.
Wait a minute now. Hold it. No.
She's forcing me to go to Canada.
Oh.
You may not come back.
That's right.
I'll be gone to Canada. I'll be in
checking
Florida
it out.
April 27th to May 2nd, and then in Canada May 5th through May 12th. So
nice.
I'm not even going to be here for most of the stuff that I'm agitating. This comes under the heading of thinking of things for other people to do. So I'm announcing right now that unless one of y'all wants to take responsibility for organizing the Job with Justice meeting next week or next month, second Wednesday, then there won't be one.
We're going to be busy, so.
What will be happening is just one hell of a lot of organized, a whole lot of activities.
Yeah.
And we definitely belong in it together. Yeah. Whether you're an Occupy videographer.
I like to call myself a citizen journalist, but I don't get many people looking at my website.
Or just an old broken down retiree like me.
Give me your URL. I'll give you my business card.
We can pull this off together. Let's have a party over at the iron workers' office as soon as they're ready.
That'd be cool. Uh-huh. Yeah.
Job with Justice, eager to sponsor there.
Good way to kick off the summer.
Sure.
Yeah.
We got $1,000 of their money, so.
Well, exactly.
At least we can do is.
At least they can do is have a party for us.
we have a hand building effort from Banner in downtown tomorrow. We're looking for a few volunteers on Pearl Street.
On Pearl Street?
If you want to get Ryan's number, you can reach Ryan. It's going to be at 10 a.m. Beck, you remember Beck Construction Company, Gene?
Yeah.
Well, we're going to be protesting. They're getting an award. You want to tell them about it?
That's great.
You were doing pretty well.
Oh, go ahead.
Beck got Great Western on at least two jobs right now, one at SMU and one in downtown Fort Worth. And I'm sure a lot of y'all know about all the issues going on with Great Western, particularly health and safety issues. Well, Beck, who contracts Great Western, is actually getting an award as one of the healthiest employers in Dallas. Mm-hmm. So we're just going to have a banner there with some handbills to sort of, you know, say that we would like them to extend their health standards, you know, to their subcontractors as well.
Cool.
So,
so that'll be 10 o'clock on what?
It'll be at the Marriott on Pearl Street downtown.
Pearl Street downtown.
We're going to sure get to know all these hotels, aren't we? Well.
Yeah, but we don't stay at them. We wave signs at them.
Best places to mobilize.
Wave signs at them.
Yeah, my number is 706-537-0212.
I'll be a bit busy playing softball tomorrow morning.
I just want to mention, you know, Gene has helped the ironworkers for a long time around here. And
yes.
The workers, rights board and everything. We had workers testifying and everything else. And we had some deplorable conditions in the construction industry in this area. There's a lot of wage theft going on. There's federal highway projects, federal dollars being utilized. Workers are not even getting paid. And I've personally been trying to get them, you know, going after wage theft. So there's a lot of issues we have, and the wages are the same today as they were in 1982 in construction in this area. Some of the lowest wages in the country. I work for the Ironworkers International Union. I cover the entire U.S. I have campaigns in Tennessee and Michigan, Wisconsin, several other states, and down here is the lowest wage we've ever seen. But we've been making some real good inroads here. We organized over about 260 new members in the last 6 months here in Texas, and we have more work going on here union now with the rebar industry than we've seen ever. And we got work right here in Arlington, Gene, at the General Motors plant, and we're putting people to work back. Western workers are going to work there.
I'll be darned. Good.
So we're really making some good headway. I just got word today that we're going to sign another contractor in Houston next week.
That's incredible. When they came in, when they first came to the Job of Justice meeting about 10 years ago, they didn't have a single rebar member in Texas.
Wow. Good darn.
And just the work that they've done is really incredible. Mm. Anybody else got anything?
Yeah, can I throw in something else about the iron workers? During the campaign, the Texas Fair Trade Coalition was running against the three free trade agreements that were passed in October. The reason Congressman Reyes, Sylvester Reyes from El Paso, who had voted for every free trade agreement except CAFTA the entire time he was in office, the reason he voted against all three, I believe, is because of Jared Strange, who is a West Texas organizer for 263 is the local for the iron workers, and Mike Cunningham, the Texas Building Trades president. But we had very little presence. I knew very few people. The whole time I've been working for the TFTC, I haven't had the funds to go to El Paso and spend any real time. But Jared Strange with iron workers and Mike with the president of Texas Building Trades really kept the issue up front. They had a meeting of all 40 labor leaders in El Paso with the congressman. They made that a really big issue, and he voted against all three. It was really one of the stunners of the vote, and so they love the iron workers.
You say you do work up in Wisconsin too?
Yes.
Can you handicap the recall effort there against the guy who started all this craziness, Scott Walker?
Yeah, I was actually in a meeting on Monday Central Wisconsin, and he's going to get recalled. It looks real well that he's going to get recalled. There's a lot of support out there right now. And, you know, Walker, they're spending a lot of money to defend Walker now. You're starting to see signs being put up, you know, billboards on cars and things like that. But there's such a movement out there. There's from every corner, every small town that the labor and community came real well together.
Yeah,
and that's what it's all about, you know. I mean, it's not just labor people. There's a lot of IWJ's been in there, and Jobs of Justice, and a lot of other groups been in there. and just bringing the people together. So it's great movement.
That's why it works.
I live in Michigan too, so we got
to
fight there also.
Oh God, you got to boy. That's Rachel Maddow is really covering y'all guys.
Mm-hmm.
Boy,
she's doing a great job.
Yeah, but Lord,
like you're losing democracy or something, right?
We are. In the Midwest, they're taking away. They just keep chipping away out in the Midwest. So
man.
Fighting back, and you know, Wisconsin, I think, has got more going on in Michigan right now, but it's starting to grow in Michigan too.
Good.
There's a lot of people coming together right now.
Cool. Well, all the best.
You too scared?
Acuete. You haven't